We have a new CLI called Octopus, and I'd like to show you how it works. You can grab the new CLI at our repo, which is slash CLI. There you'll see detailed instructions on how to download and install the tool. You can curl download and run this tool within a bash session. We have a number of MSIs and packages available on Chocolaty, on Homebrew. We have detailed instructions on installing this in Linux, etc. So you have all the instructions that you need there to download and install this tool. Let's take a look at the tool itself. This is the new CLI. It's called Octopus and provides a number of commands for you to manage resources on your Octopus deploy instance. So with the CLI, I can do things like manage deployment targets, packages, projects, projects groups, releases, runbooks, tasks, tenants. There's a lot of stuff here. I can also now navigate a config system. I can manage spaces. I can manage accounts. I can manage environments. So for those folks who have used the old CLI, this is radically different and much improved. Let's put this through its paces. We'll start by taking a look at the config system. The config system underpins the CLI and provides a set of values that it will use when connecting to an instance of Octopus. So here you can see I'm hitting my cloud instance at bristo.octopus.app. I have an API key that is start out, and I'm specifying other things like my default format for output. Let's take a look at an example where I want to, say, get a list of projects. This is one of many commands that we have. If I wanted to see the command itself, I can simply navigate to its root, and you can see all the subcommands that we support. Another thing that we've built in is the ability to obviously do tab completion, which is pretty cool. So if I forget a command, that's fine. If I mistype a command, we provide you with some hints. If I go to the root of the Octopus experience here, I can navigate the commands as well. So I can simply tab and navigate the commands. So that's pretty cool. Another thing that we realized early on when using the CLI is that it can be a lot better of experience for customers. So for example, typically when you run a CLI, it will simply drop you on the floor because you don't provide the necessary parameters. And so one of the things that we took to heart was to provide a human-first experience around the CLI. The CLI itself will now realize that, hey, I didn't provide enough parameters, so we'll kick you into a new mode called interaction mode. And what this does is provide you a human-first experience. So it'll ask you a series of questions and answers, and it will provide you that context to create or perform other operations against various resources in Octopus. So I'll create a new project here. So we'll call this, for lack of a better term, foo. And you'll notice here we actually have a select option here. This allows me to select a variety of different resources, in this case, life cycles. It is also filterable, so I can type something here if I wanted to, and I'll get a detailed list. And oftentimes, this is great if you've got, say, thousands of projects or thousands of environments or life cycles, and you want to filter them by its name. You can do that simply by starting to type it in. I'll select test here, and you'll notice that I'll also get the same prompt here for the project group that it falls under. So I'll create it as in the default project group. And then we'll ask me, do you want to use this with config as code? And by default, we say no, just because that's the default in the portal. But if I wanted to, I could set this up with config as code easily. You'll notice that a default option here for a yes/no question, the one that is capitalized is the default. So I'll select no. Now, one thing you might notice here is this is a little bit different, right? We've created a project, and one of the things we do is we actually show you a link. Hey, this is where that project can be found. So this is the project that I just created. You can see there its name is called foo, obviously. And this is something that we took to heart when reading through the command line interface guidelines. This is the document that we lived and breathed by. This was sort of our Bible when building out the new CLI. And what this is basically a whole set of best practices, tips, and tricks about when you're building out a CLI. These are some of the things that will enhance the user experience. And one of the things that they recommended is making sure that you drive behavior back to the common default. So in this case, the portal. And so that's why we provide links for pretty much anything that you do in terms of a create operation. So if you create a new project or you create a new release, etc., these and other types of operations will emit a URL. The other thing that we wanted to do was make sure that we emit any automation commands as well. So when you perform a command like this in interactive mode, we will also generate for you the automation command. We want the CLI to be kind of like a teaching tool. So if you want to run this command, in, say, a background process, like in a CI workflow or some daemon or something like that, you can go ahead and do so using this automation command. So that is something that we've built in across every command that you have inside of the CLI, which is awesome. And again, that speaks to the philosophies that were espoused by this lovely document here. So if you want, you can also run other commands. So let's take a look at something else. Let's go ahead and create a release. So the release command has a bunch of subcommands: create, delete, deploy, and list. Let's create a new release. And I will do this for the super duper awesome project. So this is my super secret, don't tell anyone type project. It will then ask me, because I have a deployment process associated with this, I have a package associated with this, I can choose if I want to change the version for this. We do have integrated help throughout the entire tool to guide you through the process of using the CLI. So we're taking that to heart when providing a help context as well. I'll accept those parameters. It will then provide me with a default release version. You can see I've released already 0.0.1. I'll choose 0.2. And then this feature, which is kind of cool, we can launch into an external editor if we want. So a release notes are basically, you know, the notes associated with the release, and they can be quite detailed. So rather than providing a single line, I can actually kick over to an editor like Pico here, and these are the release notes. And then once done, I can simply say, yep, commit those, and it will use those in concert with the command itself when executing it through the CLI. So this is a really nice feature because a lot of customers, when working with interactive mode, they oftentimes don't have an editor right beside them, or we can just kick into their default editor. In fact, that's part of the configs. If you take a look at the configs themselves, they will be listing your default editor for that experience. So you can see here we kicked off the release. The automation command has been generated, and we've also got a link to that release itself. So if we open that up, you can see it here. This is the release that we generated. And now let's go ahead and deploy that release. So go back here, we'll say release. And maybe I'm lazy. Hey, I'll use the tab completion. We'll go crawl create. And if I don't provide all the parameters, that's fine. I can simply, you know, use interactive mode. So I'll jump over to super duper awesome. And rather than creating, let's go ahead and deploy it. My apologies. So we'll deploy this. And it will ask me what release do I want to deploy. So I'll choose that one. It will then ask me what environments do I want to deploy to. So this is a multi-select option we've built into the CLI. So you can hit space to select an option. You can hit right arrow to select them all, left arrow to delete, to not select any of them. I can filter these based on the type of name, etc. So I'll choose the first one and move on. And then if I want, I can change any of the options here as well. So you can change things like the deployment time. We have this really cool date time picker. I can choose whether or not I want to skip any steps in my deployment process. I'll choose to run that. And then I can select things like guided failure mode, caching packages, etc. So it's gone ahead and created this release and deployed it. And now if we go ahead and open the link here, we can then see the deployment itself has executed, which is fantastic. So that's another operation that you can run. So if we take a look at the CLI itself, again, there are other commands that we can take a look at. So we've done releases, we've created a project, we've listed them. Let's take a look at, for example, we can take a look at the account command. So the account command allows you to create and delete a variety of account types. So you can create AWS accounts, Azure subscription accounts, GCP accounts, and we will do right by the various accounts for them. So if I want to create a username and password account, I can go ahead and do so. I'll give it a name, for example, like let's choose something really descriptive like bar. I can give it a name, I can give a username, I can specify a password, etc. So these and other types of operations I can do. As I mentioned before, we also have the ability to work with spaces. So you can see these are some example spaces I've been messing around with. And I can, if I so choose, I can actually delete one of these. So I'll choose to delete a space and I'll maybe select this one. It will prompt to confirm that you want to delete this space. And when you go ahead and do so, it will delete that space accordingly. So for scripting and for utilizing in the context of script runs, this is really powerful. You haven't had the ability to do this before, so we've provided that out of the box, which is fantastic. So again, this is the new CLI, and it's got a lot of great features. And what I'd like to do now is I'll show you some examples that we have started building out. So we oftentimes get a lot of questions from customers, and they would like to see how they could use this in a script context. So we have this examples file that we've been building out where you can see some examples of things that you can do with the new CLI. So upload package, create and deploy release, create tenant and deployment target. This one is using the AZ or Azure CLI in concert with our new CLI. You can see how this will greatly reduce the amount of lines of code you have to write in your scripts to use this CLI. Oftentimes, if you're targeting our REST API, there's tens, if not hundreds of lines of code you have to write in your scripts to do the same type of operations we're doing here. As I said before, we're trying to make this quite composable. In fact, we're big believers in single responsibility. And so when you, for example, list the available deployment targets, you can specify an output flag like JSON. So to show you an example here, I'll take a list of spaces and I'll specify the output flag to be JSON. So we'll emit that out and then you can pipe that into a tool like JQ that will allow me to run a query against the result set and then find something that I'm interested in. We can register SSH endpoints, bulk delete releases by created dates, create projects, etc., etc. So there's lots of power and flexibility in the new CLI. The new CLI, as I said before, is built in Go. It uses the Go API client, the same one that we use in the Terraform provider. And we provide, as I said, detailed instructions on how to download and install this thing. In terms of size, it's a lot smaller than the old CLI and is a lot faster. And part of the reason why it's faster is because we're utilizing the new executions API for a variety of operations, including runbook, create release, deploy release, etc. And the new executions API is vastly more performant than the old APIs. So this was a blog post I wrote a while back that talked about the performance improvements we got in the new executions API, and the new CLI takes advantage of that. So if you're at all interested, you can go ahead and check out our repo, which is at /CLI, and you can download a version of this and it will run across pretty much any system with zero dependencies. So we hope you like it and can't wait to hear your feedback.